And asked to make a video about the how and why of hiding yourself energetically. So let's start a little bit with the why. If we do anything, we leave a fingerprint, just like when we touch anything, we leave a physical fingerprint. Also, when we make an energetic contact, we leave an energetic fingerprint. So energy is always flowing. So if we just tap a person on their shoulder, we're already a little bit of my energy is flowing into them and a little bit of their energy is flowing into me. So it's a very natural process to leave these traces. And it's only through conscious effort that we can not leave traces. Energy generally flows from high to low, so the easiest way to not leave prints is basically to absorb energy rather than to release energy. So if you put yourself in a very calm or in a rather somehow depressed energetic state, energy will tend to flow to you rather than outwards. So you effectively become a little bit invisible, just like a black hole is invisible because no light escapes it. Even though it is sending out light, it is all energies are in a way just flowing back. This is also a structure you can create in your aura and you can train yourself. Normally, when we are interested in something, our aura extends like a little tentacle towards the thing we are curious about. So we're always deforming our aura to contact this or that or to touch this or that with our attention. What we can do is, rather than being relatively intrusive, like going there with our energy, is summoning the energy, allowing the energy to come to us, to absorb the energy from our environment, to listen very carefully, and to in a way create an opening or an invitation for this energy to come to us. So this is also a way to leave less energetic prints. What we can also do is modeling. If we don't want to make an energetic contact with a person directly, we can also create a kind of a model, like, okay, what would that person be like? How would they react? And then just study the model we have. The model can be, in a way, an analytical or imaginary model that we just go by what we know or have observed from that person to create a kind of a energetic clone which we can study. We can also use an intermediary. So if something holds the energy of the person, like for instance their photograph, their name, their watch, their mobile phone, their keys, something, or their clothes, their hair, their nails, blood, sperm, all these things hold the energy of the person. And this energy, if you connect it with a little bit of life force, can be in a way brought to flow, to move. So we can create kind of a clone of the person from their own energies. You can also use this technique to bypass a person's defenses even. If a person is very like refusing contact, the person can refuse that contact, but the hair or the nails or whatever they left behind, they don't have this defense mechanism that the person itself has. So you can study it through such a clone. That doesn't give you immediate access to the person either, because the person still has their defenses, but at least you can more or less unobtrusively study somebody else. Many people also make it difficult to be studied, and they do this by creating a lot of motion or layers in their auras, so that every time you look, you see a mask. If you look beyond that mask, you see another mask. If you look beyond that mask, you see another mask. And it can be very hard to find the core. What is the person really like? So we can have all these different layers in our auras as a matter of protection. What we also can do is, before we do something and we don't want to leave our energetic prints, we can change our aura or our energy body and go in a state which is not very normal for us. So when a person starts backtracking or looking for who this might have been, they won't find us. They will just end up with somebody else who's more matching the role you play. So you can imagine yourself to be somebody else. You can change your energy body to be somebody else. And then whoever is looking for you will usually see that false image and go after that false image if they're trying to hunt you down. Another safe way is to work through intermediaries. So, for instance, in the past I used to make contact with the spirits of the deceased, dead humans. And at a certain point I found this to be very unhealthy for me, not good for me, because these often dead people, they're longing to prolong their existence, they're longing to return to life. So they tend to want to use my life force or take my life force, or they want to take possession of my body. And also, even if that wouldn't happen, by their exposure and interchange of energies, my own energy vibration would become more and more similar to theirs. So after I would leave my own physical body, I would end up in this place where all these lost spirits are wandering about, unable to move on, unable to reincarnate, at least for a while. So I would prefer not to have this intense energetic contact, but sometimes I do need some information they can provide. And I do this by using an intermediary. So I would ask one of my spirit guides maybe to go there and make a contact for me. So rather than making this contact directly, I will have the spirit guide going on an errand for me and bringing back the information I want. Rather than using an already existing spirit guide, you can also create an energetic being, which can be of ethereal nature or astral nature, which you can send on errands to collect energy or information for you. This can be called a familiar or an imp, which is in a way your ally in these other levels of existence. And of course you don't want anything to happen to your ally, but sometimes it can be better that it happens to your ally or your construct, because it would be even better if something is risky to send a construct than your own core being. It's also possible to make a copy of yourself, and of course this copy of yourself has a lot of your abilities and insights, but it will also make it easier for your opponent to find you as well. So using a copy of self, you're choosing in a way power over secrecy if you create such a duplicate. Another method is in a way to build alliances or to make deals. So sometimes there are powers which are more or less mercenary in nature, who are willing to do something for you if you do something for them. And this is also a way to keep your own identity hidden in your energetic world. Or when you're doing these activities. Another option is to work with the energy of the void or the energy of chaos. Chaos and void energies are a lot harder to control, but the advantage is that they can pretty much erase everything and remove things from existence. So for removing your tracks or not showing what you have done, these energies can be useful allies. Another thing which is also important to do is to calm yourself, in a way, to meditate, so you will make the least possible imprint. It's like treading lightly. If you are, for instance, influencing somebody else and you're very emotional, you're angry at them or jealous of them or envious, then often this emotional imprint will create also a very strong footprint on the person or even on the objects which you're touching. So never make food if you're in such a mood, because yeah, the food itself will bring this negative energy back to you. So it is best to work if you're in a very neutral state, in almost an uncaring state, where at least your emotional imprint won't be there. There can still be another, a more subtle imprint of your mind, of your thoughts, which can also be stilled, of course, by practicing what you will do, so it becomes more or less automatic, so you won't have to think about what to do, and you can act more or less neutrally, like a machine would. So these are also methods of reducing your energetic footprint. Another way to work is to work with a group energy. So if you blend your energy in with many others, and then use the energy of the group to do something, look somewhere, get something, then the print will be of the group. And the target of any retribution will also be the group, rather than you specifically. And especially in the more darker magical circles, this technique is often used. So in a way, the other group members are used as human shields for the lead magician, who is utilizing the group energy for their own purposes. So, also to the why. If a person has your energetic signature, they can easily find you, and not only you, but also through you, they can find your loved ones, the place where you live. And all these, this whole image of you, your environment, your connections, can then be exploited in a counterattack. So your environment can be used against you, also your loved ones can be used against you, both as a weapon or as a tool for blackmail. Like if you don't stop what you're doing, or if you don't leave us alone, or if you don't do what we want, we will, for instance, harm or kill somebody you love or care about or are dependent on. This can be a blackmail system. They could also use your weakness for them. So if your own defenses are too strong for any curses or magical attacks to penetrate, they can, in a way, plant such a curse in your lover or in your friend or in your pet. And because you're open and unsuspecting to them, this same curse, which cannot affect you directly, can move through such a lover or pet or friend into you. Same with the environment. Your environment can be used against you to poison you with negative energies, to lay traps, or just to spy on you by placing there certain watcher spirits who will report on your activities, or even at moments when you're vulnerable. So you won't get attacked if you're strong, but at the moment that you fall ill, you're sleeping, you're exhausted, you're tired, then it will alert your enemies, and they will seize the opportunity to attack you when you're at your weakest. So these are several reasons why you might not want to leave any prints for others to exploit. It's a very big topic. There's many strategies and counter-strategies. And it's also a continuously evolving field, spiritual warfare, where all the time new weapons and new defenses are being developed. So it's a little bit generalized how I went into it. If there's more specific questions, you can email me and we can try to make another video about how to work with a